Six things you need to know before buying a thermal camera for elevated body temperature screening. Hi, I'm Marcus Terran with Movitherm, and I put this video together to help you guys out to make a decision if you're in the market for purchasing a thermal camera for temperature screening to see what is important and what is not. Before we get started, please make sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel. You can also leave any sort of questions and comments below, and as always, I'll make sure to answer every single one of them. With this, let's get started. Let's first talk about how a thermal camera works. A thermal camera takes the radiated infrared energy from the surface of a solid object, and then the captured energy is being mathematically converted to a temperature reading. The temperature reading of each pixel of the camera is then being associated with a color representing a temperature. You can see that sort of thermal image effect down here. And this is actually a thermal image of my face. The absolute accuracy of a thermal camera depends on many factors. Considering all factors, such as emissivity, spatial resolution, detector and system noise, temperature drift, and etc., the expected accuracy of these cameras is no better than plus minus 2 degrees Celsius or plus minus 3.6 degrees Fahrenheit. Tip number two, what can a thermal camera detect? A thermal camera can only detect, measure, and document the variations of skin surface temperatures. It cannot detect or diagnose any of the following: if somebody has a fever or not, if somebody is sick or healthy, if somebody has an infection of any kind, or if somebody is contagious or not. This is often a big misconception out there. A diagnostic decision can only be rendered by a healthcare professional using other FDA-approved methods, such as a fever thermometer, blood tests, or viral tests. A thermal camera used for this application requires an FDA 510K clearance. With such a clearance, it can be used as an adjunct screening tool for skin surface temperature measurements. Tip number three, how to properly measure elevated body temperature. Body temperature is correlated the closest at the inner canthus or tear duct area. I'll demonstrate this here on the thermal image. This region right here and this region right there. That is essentially the only region in the face that is properly correlated to the inner core body temperature. Everything else in the face does not count. Therefore, measuring skin surface temperatures anywhere else in the face will not work properly. Eyewear will obstruct the tear ducts and must be removed before the measurement. A person should be standing still at a fixed distance to the camera. Tip number four, what camera pixel resolution do I need? The tear duct area that we discussed in the previous slide is about 5 millimeters. We need at a minimum 3 pixels to cover that region for an accurate measurement. So if we take 5 millimeters divided over 3 pixels, we get 1.6 millimeters per pixel resolution. Using a thermal camera with 320 pixels, we can capture an image size of 320 pixels times 1.6 millimeters per pixels equal to 512 millimeters or 20 inches. Using a camera with only 160 pixel resolution, we're left with an image size of only 10 inches. Therefore, pointing a camera into a crowd to detect elevated body temperature will not work. Assuming an image size of 5 feet, it would require a thermal camera with more than 12 megapixels, and these do not exist. Tip number five. Reference black body versus reference population. There are two legitimate measurement setups available for elevated body temperature measurements. One uses an external black body reference to increase the accuracy of the measurement to about 0.5 degrees Celsius or better. The other one uses a relative comparison of skin surface temperatures based on a baseline group. Both of these setups are valid and require a manual correction from time to time, to account for external factors that are impacting the thermoregulation of the human body. Thermoregulation is the ability of the human body to keep its inner core temperature stable. Core body temperature is 36.4 degrees to 37.1 degrees Celsius, or 97.5 to 98.8 degrees in Fahrenheit. The body will either try to conserve energy or try to get rid of excess energy to maintain its ideal core temperature. This results in increased or decreased skin surface temperatures, as the skin is the interface to the environment. Tip number 6, which solution can I trust? Be aware of ambulance chasers. More than 30 new solutions and companies have been created in the past 2 months alone. Work only with reputable companies with a proven track record. A great question to ask is also, how long has the solution they are selling been on the market? Was it successfully used during the previous pandemics, such as SARS and swine flu? Be aware of false camera accuracy claims. Be aware of fully automated systems. Be aware of low-cost solutions. Do not buy a solution that claims to be able to scan more than one person at a time, such as crowd scanning solutions. Be aware of any other false claims in the marketing materials and on their websites. For instance, fever detection, avoid spreading of infections, any diagnostic claims, keeping you safe, and so forth. Not all thermal camera solutions are created equal. So which camera is the right one to use? I have listed one option here, and that's the FLIR A320 TEM screen. This camera was originally developed for previous pandemics such as SARS and swine flu. This camera also has been installed thousands of times around the world at airports and public buildings. It is a proven solution, tried and tested. It also has an FDA 510K clearance for skin surface temperature measurements. There's other options available as well, but this is kind of the de facto standard for this sort of application. If you like this video, make sure you are subscribing to this channel and giving us the thumbs up. This helps us to push this video to more people. Also, make sure to check out the description section in this video for more information. Thanks for watching, and I hope you like this. I'll see you soon. Thanks. Bye-bye.